father was a pastor. Church was my life from very young, and the Christian tradition just is my heritage. I am a minister in the United Church of Canada, a pastor. My name is Allison Huntley. I'm very happy to be able to share my story with you as gay Christian. No, lesbian Christian. I'm now 60 years old. So when I was 19 or 20, in Canadian society, homosexuality was not universally accepted. There was at that time in society a sense of fear. People would lose their jobs in society. It was hard to get housing. There was all sorts of repression of gay and lesbian people. There was a lot of violence. So there was a climate of fear, but not of shame. I wanted personal security. I suppose I believed that marriage was a more secure place to be. I want a committed long-term relationship. I wanted to have children, so I was married.
When you decide to marry a man, did you aware that your identity?
We talked about it. He was aware. I think we thought there's a way to make this work, that we loved each other, and the difference between being in a relationship where you love somebody with all of yourself is different. That you could be loving of somebody like a brother, like a relative, and very much care about that person, but that's not the same as being fully who you are. And for me, the experience of discovering that difference, eventually there was such pain in myself, there was such a sense of pain and conflict, I couldn't do it anymore. I couldn't live with that part of myself kind of cut off. It was as though I had cut off my body. It was a painful decision. Because I was torn between Christian values of, you know, if you marry, it's for life, and that was my commitment. At the same time, realizing that I was becoming increasingly depressed, increasingly unable to hold these pieces together. I cannot say that it was for the best for everybody, because it was painful for my children, it was painful for my spouse. It was what I needed to do, and I regret the pain it caused others. But in a way, it freed up my husband. He remarried, and he is with somebody who also is loving him fully and completely. I'm still friends with my former husband. I think come to a deeper place of healing, and as a family now, when we gather with my former husband and his spouse and their stepchildren and our children, two of my children are adopted, so their birth mother is also part of this gathering. We live with considerable diversity in our own family, and grandchildren, and my partner, of course. When Andrea, my partner, and I got married, somebody said to us, "You don't have a family tree, you know, the family tree, you have a family thicket." Thicket means just simply a growth of a whole bunch of trees growing together. It could be a forest. It's that image. It was positive. I think there had been a tendency in the church, and in some traditions still is, to say it's okay, you can be homosexual, but don't do anything about it, be celibate. But to say you can never express that part of yourself, I think is very, very sad. That's a condemnation, it's a cutting off of who that person is. I think there's a belief there still in Canada and sometimes in conservative Christianity that if homosexuals wanted to, they could change who they are. Sexuality is a part of who we are. It's not just some add-on behavior. But I don't think either that it is very easy for people to change their minds on this issue. For me, I would say one of the life-changing, you know, mind-changing things in my experience was discovering how privileged I am as a white person. I didn't want to know I had white privilege. I didn't want to change my mind about that. But realizing that whiteness is a privilege, opening my mind and my heart to the racism that is in me and in our society, transforms me, because it allows me to more deeply engage with other people. I think in the same way, it's not easy for us to discover homophobia in ourselves and be willing to change that. And I did believe that we were on a journey that would lead to greater compassion, greater love, that love is stronger than hatred. And I still believe that. I know that, because I see it. So I can look now at hatred and say, it's strong, but it's not as strong as love. That's our Christian story, right? You know, they could kill him, but they couldn't. The spirit of love rose from the dead. So we know that. We know about resurrection. I'm not sure cheered them up because it's a very painful time. And I know our church, it was extraordinarily painful. There was a time in Korea where these conversations could never have happened. And this is true in Canada, where it was so hidden you could not even have that conversation. So there has been change. There will be change. It will not be fast. Protect your young, you know, while this is happening as best you can. Stick together. Pray hard. Feel God's Spirit move in us.